came here to party. I'm not gonna lie. So call up somebody. Cause I ain't got the time. No, no. I'm feeling myself in the best way. I'm gonna pretend it's my birthday. Got all my friends going crazy. Cause this is how we do. We'll go dancing in the club on a Saturday night. Go driving down Sunset.
Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down and to Weston Park 2022 International Model Air Show. Remember to like and subscribe to support the channel. And we're here with our 3D scanning and printing business, where we'll hopefully scan some customers and print them like this for the model aeroplanes. But first, let's catch some show highlights.
Over the weekend, there were lots of big, impressive models, ones that you wouldn't usually see at your local club. First, we have this large turbine-powered British Aerospace Hawk from the CARF range of models. The Hawk was developed as a jet trainer by Hawker Siddeley. And this model was finished in the colours of the RAF's 2010 solo display team, based at Four Flying Training School at RAF Valley. These big jet models coped well with the blustery conditions and strong crosswind. Next up, we have a pair of large-scale World War II American carrier-based fighters. With the Grumman F-8F Bearcat and the Vought F-4U Corsair. The Bearcat was introduced late into World War II and was Grumman's last piston-engine fighter. Meanwhile, the Corsair saw service in World War II and in the Korean War. It was designed with its distinctive inverted gull wings to provide ground clearance for its enormous propeller. The design served with the US Navy, the US Marine Corps, the Royal Navy and the Royal New Zealand Air Force. These big, imposing models are to a scale of approximately 1 to 5. And are built from the Nick Zeroli plans. Over the weekend, we were treated to some displays from some of the world's top international aerobatic pilots. This is Raquel Bello, also known as Lady 3D.
Behind her back, that's her signature manoeuvre, just riding with Martin. They're a good team. Raquel Bello here at Weston Park. Lovely to see you, Raquel.
She's the official team pilot of Heliprofessional with Soxos Helicopters, and here she is flying her Strike 7.1.
Let's watch the grass, watch the grass, watch the grass. Here it goes. Blade scrape, blade scrape.
Go on, girl. You can do it. You can always do. Go on, go on. Go on! Yes, baby!
I'll put a link up here where you can check out her own YouTube channel.
So we've got this time, we've got gin.
Next, we have a duo display of these North American OV10 Broncos from the Hangar 9 kits.
Broncos. These are the Hangar 9 Broncos.
These kits are almost ready to fly, but they're absolutely enormous, with a span of 108 inches. Each was powered by a pair of 35cc two-stroke petrol engines. They're equipped with Jetty radio gear and flown by Jamie Privett and Sid Jackson.
Tim's from Cambridge, and always like to see these Broncos.
The type was designed for light strike and counter-insurgency roles and introduced for the Vietnam War. However, the type remained in US service until 1995, and there's still a few serving for NASA. This rugged twin turboprop has brilliant short field performance, which made it ideal for development into firefighting and even crop dusting roles.
And the Broncos going to make a tandem touchdown, I would have thought. There we go, look at this. Here we are. Wonderful. The Hangar 9 Broncos. Well done, gentlemen. So, turbo props.
As well as the flying and the model traders, there was also a swap meet, which was really busy all weekend. We had lots of second-hand planes, as well as some older builder's kits and lots of engines for sale. There were also quite a few craft stalls to keep the whole family occupied. And the British Gliding Association had this full-size glider simulator, where you could try your hand at full-size gliding under the watchful eye of an instructor.
Running anti-smoke oil. This thing is 50 years old, this plane. Goodness me, you wouldn't have thought so, would you? And then we got a great young pilot, Joe Hampson.
Next, we have a display with this Pilatus PC-21 from the Tomahawk kit. It's an all-composite design and is powered with a miniature turboprop engine. The full size is a high-performance military trainer. The model had a smoke system, which worked by injecting smoke oil into the jet exhaust. There were many sport jets flown, such as this Super Scorpion from Aviation Designs. They were perfect for carving through the boisterous winds. but in the evening, when it cooled down, the wind calmed down to allow some relaxed off-the-peg flying. We love this part of the show, where the campers can mingle with the top show pilots and enjoy some model flying together. We caught the Team AZ Aerosports lads having fun with these foam Cessna 182 models from the HSD Jets range. We also saw them bombing around with these F-86 Sabres from the Arrows hobby range, just like the one that we've recently reviewed and modified here on the channel. The weather wasn't as kind to us on the Saturday. However, in between the downpours, we got to see this gorgeous Blériot model. This was flown in a very scale-like manner by Dave Johnson, the chairman of the Large Model Association. The model was of an unusual prototype Blériot that featured ailerons rather than wing warping controls. As the evening drew on, the showers drifted away and the carnival atmosphere of the show returned for the fireworks. The enthusiasm from Nick Johnson, the show commentator, really whipped the crowds up into a party atmosphere. The highlight of the evening was this fabulous full-size display from the Global Stars aerobatics team. Mark Jeffries leads this team of Extra 300 and Cat 232 aeroplanes. This display looks stunning against the colourful sky, and this was the actual colour. I'm not using any filters or anything. Once again, a big thanks to Steve Bishop and his team for organising a fabulous show. We had a brilliant, busy weekend. We'd like to thank everyone who came along to get scanned at our stall. Our 3D printers will be busy for the next few weeks. We're already looking forward to next year. Thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.
go driving down Sunset Beach.